morning, everybody. I'm Mike McCooey, president of Platt Enterprises here in Atlanta, Georgia. I've been in the craft industry about 25 years, and I've known Jim Scatena for most of those years. We first met, we were both working with ACCI on the trade show committee. I was chair and Jim was on the committee, and I really didn't know him. During the course of the meeting, I kept noticing this guy raise his hand, put his hand down, raise his hand, put his hand down, asking questions, making suggestions. It was Scatena. So I turned to Bob Ferguson, who was sitting next to me. I said, "Has this guy ever put his hand down?" He said, "Nope." And so ever since then, he's never put his hand down. He's volunteered for everything he could to make this industry bigger and better. ACCI, HIA, CHA, the Wholesale Florists Association. He's been on the committees. He's chaired committees. He's been on boards. He's chaired boards. He's done everything he could for this great industry that we're all in. For me, Jim has always been a sounding board. You know, when you're president of a company, it's very difficult for other people to relate to the situations you sometimes find yourself in. And Jim, because of his experience and wisdom, has always been good counsel for me, and I always appreciate that. And on a personal note, Jim, his wife Patty, who unfortunately passed away way too early, my wife Sandra and I have had some great times over the years, sometimes after being overserved, sometimes not. But we have great memories, not just the same. And Jim's volunteerism isn't just limited to our industry. He, back in Ludington, his hometown, or as he calls it, Pittsburgh West, he's been involved in many charities. He's worked with the state of Michigan. He's worked with the Diocese of Grand Rapids. And just as unconcerned about his time as with the industry. So I think that Jim is the kind of leader that exemplifies the type of presidents we have in our industry. He is honest, he has integrity, he's hardworking, loyal, just a real Boy Scout. In fact, he happens to be the size of an average Boy Scout, but that's neither here nor there. He is a giant in our industry. I am privileged to call him my friend, and I'm honored to introduce him as the newest member of the AFCI Craft Hall of Fame. Congratulations, buddy.
Well, good morning, everyone. First of all, whoever had the idea to start this ceremony at 0:30 seems to have forgotten that I'm retired now and I don't get up this early anymore. But for this occasion, it's my pleasure. I spent 40 amazing years in the craft industry. I began my career in 1976, shortly after graduating high school, when I joined a small family-owned company in Chicago. The owner of that company, Norman Wilton, had just appointed Vince Naccarato president and general manager of his small family cake decorating company. But Vince had a vision that Wilton would become much bigger than that. And I believe to this day that Wilton, through the Wilton Method Cake Decorating Class program, was single-handedly responsible for creating hundreds of thousands, if not millions, of new consumers for the craft industry. It was a great, great time at Wilton. Then I moved over to Crayola for a couple of years, where we built a great team, and we leveraged our experience in the fine art business into the craft paint business, which was really starting to emerge then. And finally, I spent the last 19 years of my career as the styrofoam guy over at Floracraft. I met hundreds of amazing people over those 40 years. And to every one of you who said, "Jim, if you're ever in my town, make sure you stop by." Well, you better be ready. Get those eggs cooking, because I'm on my way. I do want to take a moment, seriously, to thank the selection committee from AFCI, and especially my dear friends back at the New Jersey headquarters, Donna, who I've known almost my entire career, Lydia, who's been my lifesaver, and especially Mark Hill, our amazing leader who's keeping this organization revitalized and strong. And especially three great friends that I met through my experience at HIA, CHA, and now AFCI, Jim Bremer, Larry Oligus, and my dear, dear friend, Mike McCooey. Thanks to all of you for this recognition, and I hope to see you during the show. Keep supporting AFCI. Thanks.
My name is Gail Zick, and I have nominated Robert Workman for the Hall of Fame. Robert Workman has been in our industry since 1976. He joined his father's company, which was Provo Crafts. At that time, he and his father and mother were very creative, and they eventually opened several retail stores that were called Robert's. But in the meantime, of course, they also had Provo Craft, which was a wholesaler. In total, they had 13 different retail outlets. Robert also served on the board of directors for HIA for 8 years. His primary focus was education. Actually, initially, he wanted to become a teacher and ended up in the creative industry, which is certainly the way to teach. Robert then moved on, and during his company, during his time at the company, he started in the high-tech business, and eventually he created the Cricut machine, which is world famous now and used by millions of people worldwide. He has sold his company to an investment firm, and although he maintained 40% of the company for 5 years, he went on to be a philanthropist. He has done so many wonderful things in his philanthropy. He started a company called TIFE, which stands for Teaching Individuals and Families Independence Through Enterprise. They've created a company called NRG, which helps villages in the Congo become more self-sufficient, feeding themselves and developing water sources. There's so much more about his examples of philanthropy. Human care and kindness is in his heart. Once again, he started another company, which is now called Bare Bones. And believe it or not, just this week, he was on Facebook with the governor of Puerto Rico, helping to provide shelter and electricity for those in Puerto Rico. Robert's kindness and caring for all humanity is well noted, and I will tell you, I am so proud to be a friend of Robert Workman. Thank you.
Life has a way of unfolding to people, and at least that's what I found. 1976 was the first year that I really started working in the arts and crafts business, but the lessons that I learned during those 30 years of working in that industry, I think, kind of propelled me to be creative as I went on to work in mainly the humanitarian business. After I sold Provo Craft, I decided that I would go to Africa. Our idea was that we would go there and try to help people help themselves by creating jobs. Our first years were lots and lots of failures. I remember sitting in this big field in the Dumi Plateau, and looking up to God and saying, you know, you can have this whole thing. And I said, I'm out of here. I'm not going to keep working at this. And at that time, I got a message, if not you, who? And if not now, when? And so I took a step back and I decided to go to my higher power, and rather than try to do it myself, I would get his help. And everything started turning around at that time. The idea that came to all of our minds was, what talent do we have? What have we practiced all of our lives? For the previous 30 plus years, I had been creating. And so we thought, well, why don't we create tools that can help these people, help themselves? And so out of that, we started another business called Goal Zero. The second business that was created out of that was Bare Bones Living. And I believe that they're successful because our first goal was to help people. And that's kind of been our motto, is to keep creating. All of that came from 30 years working with very creative people. I still feel just as enthusiastic today as I did in 1976 when I first started in the craft industry. My message and my hope to all my friends is that wherever they are, whatever they do, do good. Find time each day just to do good. And here's the real magic in doing good. It comes right back at you. You get good. So do good, get good. Thank you, my friends, for thinking about me and honoring not just me, but the good things that we do in this world.